who do we have? Stop the movie and watch it. Fantastic Four! I have both versions. Actually, no, I don't have both versions. Yes, I do. No, I definitely do. So I've got the 2006 version, which I watched recently, and I was like, I don't understand. And then I watched the remake, which didn't get a sequel, and now that there is rumors for the to be rebooted again, because why not, in order to fit this current MCU. So, he's actually next to my Iron Man, because we saw that before. I don't know if it's the 2006 version or the one that's later, but either way, we're still going to watch it. Okay, so that one's actually The Rise of the Silver Surfer, which you can't see. Give me a sec, let me move, God. Yeah, so Rise of the Silver Surfer, which I haven't watched in a hot minute. Okay, so that's my Marvel up the top there. Fantastic Four is right there. I'm gonna watch the 2006 version. Let me double check if I have... Oh, I've got Silver Surfer. Oh, I haven't watched that one in ages. Alright, let's see if I have the other version as well. Alright, so yeah, I do have both of them. There's a whole reason behind it, because I did a Marvel binge for my birthday. So I have both of them. I feel like the older one is a little more fun to watch, because when I watched this one, I got really bored. I was like, oh, you do all that for nothing? And then I know it was supposed to have a sequel and never did. I also know that I never saw it at cinemas because it just did not look appetizing at all. And yes, I said appetizing. But then the first time I watched this a couple of months ago, I read the synopsis and I was like, did they really have no hope for this movie? Because it says a sexy star-powered cast. Because, like, that's all we care about in movies is the looks of an actor. Like, oh no. I mean, you could actually know this one is children. You can't say the same thing about children because that's just creepy. What does it say? In the Fantastic Four Triumph Return. Whereas this one is sexy star powered cast. See, that one's children. You can't say the same thing about children. These are grown-ass adults. But I had way more fun watching this one. So I'm going to re-watch this one. Unless I don't have... give me a second. I'm going to check my letterbox. So that's a bit devoured. I don't have a letterbox review for either of those. But I'm still going to stick with the fun one because this one's a lot more fun to watch. Like I said, this one bored me. So I don't really want to watch it in a hurry. But this one is really fun. And I also remember watching this as a kid, not long after it came out on DVD, and I thought it was, like, super cheesy, but I still liked it-ish. So, I'm gonna give it another rewatch, and wonder if I still think it's as cheesy as I think it is. I mean, look, when you say sexy style-powered cars in this explosive adventure, you really had no hope besides their looks, didn't you? You factored in the fact that these had to be hot superheroes. Right, yeah. Though with this one, I can't actually remember how they got their powers. And the fact that majority of the movie, they're just building stuff. Whereas this one, they're all freaking out about their parents. Because, like, can we get that? And I know that there's been a rumored confirmation on Fantastic Four being rebooted for the third time. Apparently Margot Robbie and a bunch of other people are going to be in it. But, like, no offense, guys, but can we get, like, unknown names? I don't really want popular names playing familiar characters. I want names that I haven't heard of, or if they have been heard of, they've only been in, like, little projects and not big A-list projects already. Because that makes it more fun when it's people who get their boosted power through superhero movies. Anyway, I'm putting this on. I've said that how many times. Let's go! Look at that smoldering gaze. They're luring you in with their sexy gaze, saying, come watch us. We make superhero movies look good. I don't know what that voice was. But, like, they honestly had no hope besides the fact that they could advertise boobs, right? Jessica Alba was huge at the time. That guy was huge at the time. That guy was huge at the time. Chris Evans was huge at the time. You know, you're just going, we have hot actors in a movie where they're half naked for majority of the time, and we got a flexible woman. 2 and 2 equal bedroom antics. That's my theory on why you said sexy style started cast. Oh my god, look at how jarring that main menu is. Jesus. card. I miss main menus. They need to bring them back. Anyway, let's go. Or not. Dun, 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 dun. Sorry, who else did that as a kid? This is why people don't go to the movies with me. See you soon. Oh, they did the thingies here. How did I not realize that they did the little comic flip here too? Even though technically Marvel and Fox didn't sign anything until years later. Oh, listen to that score. I'm melting. Okay, so the opening sequence is pretty simple, but like, still pretty cool. I love how it gives you like the comic books feel. Like, and like you can still see the actor's resemblance in the drawings. Yeah. Like it gives you so much in such a short amount of time. Like I think that's really cool. And there's the bad guy! Hear that score change? Even the coloring adds to the change? Oh. Can you tell how much I'm in love already? Like, I already know it's super cheesy, but like, you have to just deal with it. Because sometimes cheesy is good to look back on. Oh, that was a nice transition. That was cool. That was pretty good. It holds up pretty well. So, you know, again, I find it hilarious that they named it Star-Studded Sexy Cast. But, like, none of them bring out, like, that sexiness. They don't have Jessica Alba wearing the skimpiest outfit possibly imaginable. They don't have her, you know, showing off ass and tits like most female-led superhero movies might have in the 2000s. The transitions from the opening sequence to the first scene, again, it's quite beautiful. Julie McMahon, he was like the face of the is he, isn't he type of character in the 2000s. Like, is he the good guy? Is he the bad guy? Like, distinctly in Charmed, he played that is he, isn't he type of guy. You know, and what I love about this is that all the characters feel natural. All the characters, we get to explore all of them. We get to explore their life before they became the Fantastic Four. We get to explore the way that they feel into coming with their powers. And get to explore, you know, that relationship of, like, not just themselves, but how they see themselves in the public eye. As well as, you know, Von Doom's character. Again, it's that progression of, well, I'm a rich guy. I'm going to do what I want. And I want you to do what I tell you to do. But that progression of, like, here's my downward spiral, and here's how it's going to come back to bite you. And I think that's very cool. Like, this is what I like about this one. Yeah, it's 2006, and surprisingly, the special effects have lasted. I think the only one that threw me out a bit was when we watched Reed stretch, and I think that's purely because, like, you can tell it's fake, and you're like, really? Sue's invisibleness kind of glitches here and there, but again, it's a 2006 movie. It's been over a decade, so the special effects are just starting to show itself now. But majority of it's filmed on location, which is why it holds up so well. And I can see that even though this is a Fox-owned movie, you can see that they were trying to do what Marvel did. They tried to introduce the characters and let them explore that realm before continuing the franchise. Just like Marvel did with Iron Man. Introduce the lone characters before throwing them in the mix. Also, there's a Stan Lee cameo that I forgot about, and MIT must be the choice of universities for Marvel, which again, I never realized until watching this, because like, every Spider-Man movie's been MIT, every, you know, even Black Panther's MIT. So, you know, I like this one. I like this one. This one's got the soft spot in my heart.